going away, Alex.
Arista, even though 2 out of 3 voters in Arapahoe County rejected this proposal, the sheriff's office says the jail still overcrowded, assaults against deputies still too frequent. But people who fought the tax hike say just throwing money at the problem isn't the only answer.
The day after a major election, the Arapahoe County Sheriff's Office says inmates are still being triple bunked and don't have enough access to mental health treatment.
We know we need to make that investment.
It's an issue county commissioners like Nancy Sharp were hoping taxpayers would help out on. With the tax increase to pay for a new jail and programs, a $460 million price tag.
Last choice is to go to the voters. I think all of us really respect that and want to make sure we're not going to the voters unless it's absolutely necessary.
But 2 out of 3 voters rejected the measure.
We want to see real investment in the county and not just for building a bigger jail.
Justin Cooper campaigned against the tax increase. He thinks stopping the influx of inmates at the front end may change the equation.
Folks who are sitting there on municipal petty offenses or any of those things that are just literally too poor to bond out, you can release those folks on personal recognizance bonds, not cash bonds.
The sheriff's office says the jail was built to house 386 people, but now it houses close to 1,200 regularly.
You can simultaneously reduce the jail population and really look at a new evaluation and say, okay, what is a legitimate fix? And what is that actual cost?
County commissioners now going back to the drawing board, saying funding a new plan may impact other projects.
There will be some tough choices to be made.
And here is another big cause for concern. Over the past 3 years, inmate assaults on deputies have gone up a whopping 120%. The sheriff's office says one deputy even breaking a femur last week in a fight. This is just an issue that can't be ignored. Alex Rose, Fox.